Well, I wanted to bring you live right after the fight in the garden here at Piperton. I didn't want them to set nothing up because I wanted you to see the true giant of professional wrestling. And I want to tell you something. I was so proud of you out there. I was so proud of the way you handled yourself out there. You really did make a gelding out of that so-called Andrea.
You know, he tried to slam me. He claims he slammed me on the strip and he fell down and he says he slammed me. And he goes and he has the guts to steal my money and he takes my money and he wants to buy himself a few friends. Well, I got a big message for you, Andrea. I'm not finished with you. You're going to pay for trying to make a fool out of Stud. Something you can't do. I make a fool out of you. Remember that.
You know, I like what you said. You know, it's exactly. First of all, he stole the money, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's trying to buy friends because he's a big goof.
Not as big as you, and you're no goof. You're one of the most intelligent men I ever met.
Andrea, big Andrea. You're a hero. You're ace one to the world. What'd he tell you? Oh, if I can't slam Stud, I'm going to retire. Well, he should be gone. You should be on a slow boat back to France. You didn't slam me. No one could slam me. The $15,000 is still up because I haven't been slammed. And I'm just going to replace that money that he stole from me to show you what kind of man I am.
And for you and a man of your structure, it'll take you about that long to replace that money.
It's already been replaced.
See, just by walking down the hall.
I'm your giant.
You
just see, remember that.
Just see, I want you folks to take a look. You're looking at three extreme individuals. Extreme because we can do something you never even thought of, huh, John?
We can beat Andre the Giant.
We can beat Mr. T and Hulk Hogan.
We can be the world champion anytime someone has the guts to put the belt up.
We can be what we want to. Don't do it. You were a